I have a mirror, and I would like it to toggle on and off when I walk in front of it. If you don't already have a mirror, go to VRChat Examples, Prefabs, and drag and drop a mirror in. But I already have one, so I don't need to. Now I need to define the area that when you walk into it will toggle the mirror on, and when you walk out of it will toggle it off. So to do so, I'm going to right click here, I'm going to go 3D Object Cube, I'm going to fly roughly in front of the mirror and go Control Shift F to place it where I am. I'm then going to get rid of any rotation the cube has, and then just roughly scale it to the size that I need. You can always tweak this later, so no need to be too precise. Now that we have this roughly where we want it to be, I'm going to get rid of the mesh renderer so we cannot see it. And I'm also going to get rid of the mesh filter because there's no point to have that. It was purely there for the mesh renderer. Now we have a box collider, so this is essentially an invisible wall. We want to hit is trigger so that we're able to walk inside of it. And then what we want to do is create an Udon behavior script component. Now we need to create a script to go inside of that. So we can right click here, go create VRChat Udon, Udon graph program, and I'm going to call this mirror script. You can call it whatever you need to call it. And now we're going to go open Udon graph. So now that we've opened the Udon graph, I'm going to create a game object variable. I'm going to call this target game object. And I'm going to create this as a public variable so that we're able to select it inside the inspector. Now that we've got our game object, we need to do something with it. So we go game object set active. And so now if I drag and drop this in, whenever this node is called, it will turn off the game object. And coincidentally, if I just duplicate that across, I can create it so that I have another one that will turn it on. So now we need to say when we want to turn it on. So we go on player trigger enter. So this is whenever the player enters the trigger, we want to turn this on. Correspondingly, we can go on player trigger exit, and this will now turn it off whenever we walk out of it. Awesome. So now what we need to do is we go to our cube and we need to tell it what program we want to run, which is the one we just created. And then we need to tell it what game object. So I'm going to come over here and drag and drop my VRChat mirror into this place. So now we need to test it. Let's test it out. So now that we're in the world, when we walk into the area, we will see that the mirror turns on. However, there is a slight problem with this method. When we bring in a second player, it turns the mirror on for them as well. We need to modify the script so that the mirror will only activate locally. Back into Unity. In order to do this, we need to reopen up our Udon graph script. And what we need to do is we need to check if the player is local. So we can go and check up the player API and do is local. This requires a VRChat API, which we can get from the trigger enter itself. And now we've got a bool to say if this is true or false, or is it the local player or is it another player? So what we now need to do is create a branch node. And what we want to do is it enters in on this end, and only if it's true will we bring it over to here. And we've got a bool value, which we're going to check out is local in. And so now when the player enters this, if it is the local player, it will work. And if it's not the local player, it will try and run the fault, which is nothing on it. Now that's all that's left is to duplicate this. So we go Control C, Control V, and then just fit it all in. Now all that's left is to build and test this, and hopefully this should work. Now we're back at this scene. If I walk in, we'll see that the mirror turns on for me, but it doesn't turn on for anyone else. So hopefully that's been helpful for you, and if you've got any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. If there's anything that I've missed, please do correct me in the comments as well, and I will see you next time. Bye!